That's funny. I didn't know Typhlosion could learn Thunder Punch. That's just crazy. Oh yeah, I could go to the move deleter, get rid of Cut, and replace it with Fire Punch. That's actually what I'm gonna do. I don't know what's wrong with the mod thing, but... To Blackthorn City! Accidentally paused the stream. God damn it, why? That's what I'm saying. Pepper is going to be a punch beast. Scope loves the Chode. I do love Chode. Chode-tastic! I wanna know what Chode is! I know you can show me! Get Cut out of here, man! Yeah! 15 more minutes till I leave. Oh, to nose. Pokemon forgot the move. Alright, now it's time for Fire Punch. Yum! Teach Fire Punch to a Pokemon. Yes. Yes! Do I plan to finish this today? I plan on it, yeah. To think, this is going on YouTube. I know. Shouldn't I be ashamed of myself? You won't miss you? Should I play Fire Red or Leaf Green? Leaf Green, everybody plays Fire Red. Mix it up, bro. I believe in this house, this lady will trade you a... If you have a Rhydon, or Rhyhorn, she'll trade you a Dragonite, or Dragon... No, Dragonair. I don't know. You need Cut in Kanto to get to Peter City. Yeah. I'll reteach it to somebody later. I think I'll put it on a slave just for a sec. How's my day gone? Pretty good, man. Natu doesn't know what a good psychic type move is. You won't miss me? Sure I will. Ugh. Wow. You know, I don't think it's mod letting me mod people, because it doesn't have me listed as a mod. Like, you know, it's weird. Like, because I don't have the things next to people's names. It's so weird. I don't know! The chat's being such a slut today. Any pets? Yes, I have two dogs. Alright, are we ready for this gym, guys? Are we ready for this? I really wish Slowbuscus was higher level. Should I go train Slowbuscus? Should I do that? Should I go... like, yes, where should I train him at? What's the best place to evolve him at? Oh, what is this guy doing there, man? That's a day of the week guy. I need to talk to him. I'm thinking Burned Tower. That would be easy for him to level up there. Yeah, yeah. Is this game? Yeah, it is. It's Santos of Saturday. Oh. Wait, it's not Saturday, is it? What is today? No, it's fucking Wednesday. Oh my god, this game is so off. Ghost type moves get stronger. Cool. Then teach him Ice Punch. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Where should I train him, though? You guys didn't say that. They're a bunch of Gravelers? Oh, good choice, good choice. I like the way you're thinking. Doesn't this guy do something? Oh, no. He just talks about his radio. I should get a Shroomish. Not in this generation, buddy. Sorry. Oh, and there's also Gligars who get owned by Surf. Yay. Good choice, good choice. I kind of want to catch a Gligar, but I don't need anybody. Oh, look, it's a Teddy Ursa! Oh, he's so cute! Oh my god. Fled, what a bitch. Oh hey, it's a Graveler. Goodbye, Graveler. Oh, 516, that's the experience I'm talking about right there. Fuck you, Tiggers. I don't want you. Okay, fine, if you want to die, I'll kill you. Or you're just gonna flee anyway. Scope, you will have the mental capability to catch the Shroomish in Pokemon. Yeah, I could, but he knows more water type. His water type move is more. What? Did I die? Oh, he used self-destruct, didn't he? Oh, the bastard. Okay, fly to Blackthorn. Oh, it's so cute. Oh, I ran away with an ass, yeah. Oh, well. What are you gonna do? So, while I'm grinding here, you guys gotta give me a story to talk about or something. How many jobs have I had? I've had two jobs. Technically speaking. If you include this one, three. But my first job was... I actually worked at the student store, which sold snacks and stuff at lunchtime in 7th grade. And they would pay you in free food. Also, that job I talked about in, like, 5th or 6th grade, I don't know if that counts, where I dropped in my pants. where I serve food, that kind of counts too. But my first real job, I was 17, and I worked at Rite Aid. It's a drugstore, and like kind of a general store. I was a cashier slash stalker. I would have to come in at 4 in the morning and like help unload stock sometimes. Worked there for a year and a half, and then I stopped working for a year and a half to go to school, and then I got the job, that restaurant job, and I was there for about a year and a half until I got this job on YouTube's. And now I'm doing this and going to school. That reminds me, I just signed up for my other classes next semester, which are Art History 1A and Computer Science 16, which is Introduction to Game Design. So, I'm so excited for that. Oh man, I'm poisoned, really? That's gonna hurt. That's gotta hurt. Oh yeah, Rite Aid has Thrifty's ice cream, which is really good. Something else I used to have to do when I worked there was I might have to stock the ice cream when it would come in the stock. So what we'd call it is you were frosty. What you'd have to do is we had this huge, like, heavy-duty snow jacket that you'd have to put on. And then you also had to put on, like, these gloves and the hood. And you'd have to, it would take, like, 30 to 45 minutes to stock all the ice cream. So you'd have to be in a below, like, a 10-degree freezer for 45 minutes. Like, in work pants and a heavy-duty thing. It was crazy. What is a Nuzlocke challenge? It's, like, a difficult challenge. It's weird. It has stupid rules, like you're only allowed to I'm poisoned again. You're only allowed to catch the first Pokemon you see on a route, and then if a Pokemon faints in your party, you're not allowed to use it anymore. It's pretty weird. Since you're going to school, does that mean you're going to get another job? I really wouldn't have time for another job, to be honest. You're here! Hello! What's up, Titanium Convoy? Stalker, yeah, I'm a stalker. Tabasco on ice cream, yeah, that's... I don't want to be reminded of that. Bad times, bad times. Talk about your crazy school stories. Oh, man. I do have some crazy school stories. I gotta think of a good one, though. What is a good one? Oh, he's trying to learn Headbutt, hell yeah. Oh, yeah, sure, learn Headbutt. Which move? Fuck Water Gun. Okay, so here's a crazy school story. We used to be in this creative writing class, me and my friends, and the way it was seated, four desks would be together at a table. You'd have two side-by-side, and then two others side-by-side facing you. So it was like a little square. And, I was at my table with my friends Kyle, DJ, and Anthony. Anthony was Asian, DJ was black, and Kyle was white, and I was white. So it was like, it was kind of diverse, it was kind of cool. And we'd always have fun in that class because we would talk about just like the craziest things. And it was creative writing, so we'd make up the funniest stories. And then we'd have open mics on Friday, so we'd like go up and tell our stories. And just a little side note, my friend Kyle, he was so crazy. What he used to do is in that class, he would go up on open mic because you get extra credit for it. And he wouldn't have had a story written. So he'd take a blank piece of paper up there and he'd make up a story as he went. And like make it look totally legit. Damn it, you graveler. And yeah, he would totally get points for it. He was cool. And then something else we used to do in that class is when we were bored, when we had free time, where we were supposed to be writing our stories, what we'd do is we would take the staplers when we had substitutes, and what we'd do is we would staple our arm. Like, no kidding, you'd open the stapler, and then we'd stab it on our arm. We'd, like, slap it on our arm so the staple would go inside of our arms. And since you're not, like, closing it or whatever, it just goes straight in, and then we'd just pull it out, you know? And the worst I ever did is I would just do it on my arm. But my friend Kyle, he was like super crazy. So what he used to do is he stapled his, you know, the skin between your pointer finger and your thumb, that little stretch of skin there. I think it's like called your angina or something like crazy like that. He stapled that. It was crazy. And then one time he tried to do it on his forehead, but it didn't work. And then the other crazy time he stapled his weenus. Which, in case you guys don't know what the weenus is, it's the skin that's, like, all loose on your elbow. You can, like, pull it. So he pulled it so that it was, like, stretching out, and then he stapled it. And he was just, like, and then he started bleeding, and it was just, he was crazy, seriously. He would do the craziest things for it, just for fun. Anyway. Angina is chest pains, really? That's hilarious. I don't know, he called it the angina, maybe he was just trolling. We were friends because it was fucking hilarious. Anyways, and then something else we used to do this, like, every day. Okay, so We were on the second floor, second story of that class, and when class would get let out, the hallway was really small, so all the classes would get let out at the same time, and the hallway would just flood with a bunch. Yeah, stapling your arm isn't that painful. I did it all the time, and it's not that bad. So basically, the halls would get crowded with all these people, so it'd be like really crowded. And, you know, so we decided we wanted to do something funny, like to make all these people in the hall laugh after class. So, of course, Kyle and DJ got the idea that we should go out and do something crazy every day after class to make people, like, laugh slash stare. So, what we did is, what we would do is we'd go outside as soon as class ended, and we'd stand in the middle of the hallway, and as people were coming out of their class, Kyle would stand there, and then I would slap him as hard as I could across the face, like, poof! And he would fall down, like, after I slapped him as hard as I could across the face. And then he would get up, and we'd act like he was really pissed, and then he'd start chasing me, and we'd run down the hallway, like, running through people, like, pushing them out of the way, and, like, and then until we got out of the second story and went to the lunch area, and then we just, like, he'd finally catch up to me, and then he'd, like, grab me, and I'd turn around, and he'd be like, oh, hey, what's up? And then we'd just, like, shake hands and, like, start walking away. It was just hilarious. People would be like, oh my god, what's going on? Because, you know, it was crazy. And we used to do different stuff, like, every day. Like, one day, we would all three, me, DJ, Anthony didn't do it because he was kind of a puss, but me, DJ, and Kyle, we would go outside, and there, at the end of the hallway, there was this two-way intersection, left or right, and then there was a wall right in front. Like, it was a wall, and you can go left or right. And we'd all run down the hallway as fast as we could, and then we'd run and jump into the wall and fall down. We'd all three do it one after another, and then we'd just be laying on a pile on top of each other, and we'd be like, oh my god, oh, like faking that it hurt so bad. And then everybody would just be like, oh my god, and be like staring at us. And then we'd get up and just walk away totally casually. It was just so funny. And thinking of stuff to do every day was just like so fun. And then eventually, you know, the people would start to get it that we were doing this shit on purpose. So every day they'd come out of class and like wonder what we were gonna do next. It was so crazy. We had so much fun in that class. Cause like, inside the class was fun, and then after class we just do crazy shit. It was just the best thing ever. It was pretty crazy. Anyway, yeah, we run into the wall. We do other crazy stuff too. Like sometimes we'd take the stapler out of the class and staple our arms and then just like scream as they're like, ah! And then we just run away. It's just, I don't know, just random things. Pretty much anything you could think of to do randomly after class, we would do it. We were crazy. We were like adrenaline junkies. That's what we were. Cause then after school, what we'd do is we'd get on our bikes and we'd go and like do bunny hops over the craziest things. And then also what we do is my friend DJ, he was a like free runner, and he was obsessed with jumping off of things and like tucking and rolling. So we'd jump off these crazy like two-story buildings, like parking garages, and yeah, and just like tuck and roll, and we'd like videotape it, put it on YouTube. It was crazy. Yeah, I really did nickname Slowpoke Slowbuscus. Yeah, you did make that up. That was your thing, I admit. It was crazy. Yeah, we were seriously adrenaline junkies. It got pretty hectic. Alright, that's level 36. One more level and Slowbuscus will evolve. But yeah, you know, it was so fun. Fun times, fun times. What else did we used to do in school? I used to sleep over at my friend's house, and me and my friend Alex and Al, we'd sleep over there because we'd like chill. And then he lived like hella far away from school, like miles, like 5, 6, 7, 10 miles. He was hella far. So to get to school at 7:15, which is when the bell rang, we'd have to leave and ride our bikes at like 6 o'clock in the morning. So we'd have to like ride, wear gloves on our hands and stuff so our hands wouldn't freeze. And then we'd like stop and get donuts. It was just great. And at that point, there's like no cars in the street, so we would ride our bikes in the middle of the street. It was great. I don't know. I mean, school was just fun. High school was so fun. If any of you guys are in high school right now, I urge you to just enjoy it, because high school is like seriously the funnest time of my life. And I've heard from so many people that's the funnest time of their life too. And seriously, like after that, it really does go downhill. It gets less and less fun. Like honestly. Like if I wasn't doing YouTube right now, my life would be so fucking boring. Oh, is that it? Nope, one more level. Oh, this should do it. But yeah, so if you're in high school right now, like, do something. Make friends, do fun stuff, just go nuts. Like, because you won't regret it later, no matter how much fuck up you do. You won't regret it later, because it'll be a fun time, you know? just, you know. I mean, I never even got drunk. I never got drunk or did anything stupid like that, or, like, didn't eat drugs. And it was still fun. You don't have to do stuff like that to have fun. You just gotta be stupid. Be a free spirit, man. Alright, here we go. Are you ready? Don't press B. What's Lobuscus is evolving? Yeah, junior year was definitely my funnest year. Senior year was easy, but it wasn't as fun. A PSA from Scope, that's right. It's Lobuscus! Don't press B, yeah, I know. I pressed B, goddammit, why? Withdraw, are you serious? Hell no. Yes. Slobuscus did not learn withdraw. Where did the shelter come from? Yeah, and that doesn't even look like a shelter at all. Alright, you know what time it is. Time to teach him Ice Punch. Let's do it, baby. Ice Punch, Ice Punch. Oh, Ice Punch. Slobuscus can learn Ice Punch. Yay! So now Slobuscus and Pepper are like eons ahead of everybody else in levels. Yeah, junior year was my funnest just because that's when I was in that one class. I just had all the classes and like, it was fun. It was just the funnest time ever. Alright, I don't know what move to get rid of here. I guess Headbutt? What do you guys think? Headbutt? Headbutt for Ice Punch? You're 17 and in 11th grade? No, I was 17 in 11th grade. Actually, I think I was still 17 in senior year. Headbutt, headbutt, shadow ball, headbutt, headbutt, headbutt. Okay, headbutt. We're getting rid of headbutt. And Slobuscus learned Ice Punch. Oh, yeah. Let's see if we got any other good TMs. We got Iron Tail and Rollout. No. Can I teach Icy Wind to anybody? We're going to need as many Ice-type moves as we can get in this place. Slobuscus, no thanks. I like Ice Punch better. What about Iron Tail? I bet Slobuscus can learn that now with his crazy tail. You're 18 in 11th grade? Oh yeah, that is pretty crazy. You're gonna be older than everybody. Fry can learn. What move was that I was just talking about? Oh, Iron Tail. Fry can learn Iron Tail. Yeah, sure, why not? I don't know what move to get rid of. He has a pretty good moveset if I remember. Well, now that Karibo has Stun Spore, I don't really need. Or now that he has Strength, I don't really need Headbutt either, but I'm gonna get rid of Glare. Hello, Turbo T Moses. Of course you made it before the end. We're not even close to the end, dude. We're almost halfway done. Swagger. No one in the corner has swagger like us. I'm not going to teach Whirlpool or Waterfall to anybody right now. Alright, let's fly back. To... God damn it, why? Blackthorn City! Oh, yeah! They see me rolling. They hating. 7 minutes and you're gonna have to go. That sucks. Scale of 1 to 10, how much do you like Pokemon? I really thoroughly enjoy Pokemon. I'd say 8. Yeah, 8. You're at Cyanwood? Well, good luck, man. Pull a Chugga and teach Whirlpool to Suicune. Yeah, because that was so funny. Oh my god, that was the funniest thing I've ever seen. Oh my god, he taught an HM to a legendary Pokemon. Wow, that's so clever. Oh my god, he's such a badass. Wow. Oh my god. Oh my god. I'm Rawful Coptering right now, in case you guys couldn't know. Rawful Copter. Yeah. Should have named your character Chameleon Air. I would That's sarcasm, hatred for Chugga. No, it's not hatred. It's just, I don't know, it wasn't funny. I mean, I would give it if it was. If it was funny, I would totally laugh at it. Alright, we're gonna put, Cool Trainer Nick in front here. Now all of our Pokemon are evolved. Are you guys excited? My Ruffle Copter goes cha 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 cha. Alright, he's got a douchebag McDouche pants here. Dragon Rage, 40 damage. Not very effective, but look how much damage you did. No, I'm stuck in an infinite loop! Oh wait, now I can switch out, sweet. Let's see how well Ice Punch works. Stop using Dragon Rage. Ice Punch for the Whizzle. Didn't that guy used to have a Seedra or something? He didn't have a Dratini. I think his other Pokemon is Seedra. No, he's got two Dratinis. This guy's crazy. Ice Punch! Thunder Wave! Ice Punch! Oh, one hit KO! You suck. Man, he's got three Dratinis. That is bullshit. Oh, fully paralyzed. You suck. Okay, who's low levels here? Fry's low level. Let's try Iron Tail out just because. Yeah, of course it missed. It always does. Your Dragon Rage is... Wait, why am I sending out Pepper? Well, why not, I guess. Yay, I'm disappointed. You should be. You're a teen until you move out. What? 18 is the legal age for an adult. What are you guys talking about? Scope, have you played the game where you put your knuckles on a table and somebody shoots a coin at your knuckles and it will start to bleed after some shots? Yeah, I remember that. I forget what that was called. Quarters, I think it was? Yeah. I've seen people play, but I never played it. I played Bloody Knuckles, but it's not fun, really. It's kind of gay, really. Oh! Yeah, 18 is pretty awesome, but no, you can't do everything. You can't do everything until you're 21. Then you can drunk. You can get drunk. Legally, at least. Look at this. What is this, lava? Speak French. I bet you have the sexiest accent ever. I don't know how to speak French. Bonjour. Bonjour, mademoiselle. Oh, wait, I can fight this guy from behind, can't I? Yeah, I'm gonna fight this guy from behind. Yeah, let's use strength. I remember this guy has a bunch of Seedras. Fight me! It matters if we all use Dragon-type Pokemon. My policy is to use Pokemon that are stronger than Dragon Pokemon. Oh, like Ice types? Scope speak. Oh, yo, he said that. I play Quarters, I'm King of Quarters. My favorite Pokemon Professor is Professor Oak. Like a boss. Like a G. Horsey! Did you play Dick in the Middle? What is that? Do I even want to know what Dick in the Middle is? In Luxembourg, you can drink at 16. Yeah, I've heard of that. So, in Mexico, you can too. Belgium, you can drink at 16. 18, you can drink legally there? Wow. Canada, you can do everything at 18. So, 21 would be the age where you become full adults. I wouldn't say full adults. That's just the age you become mature enough to moderate yourself. Would you rather get cut in half, top or bottom, or get eaten by a shark? Dude, I don't know. The water in Mexico is a jerk? Yeah, you're telling me I would never drink in Mexico. F that. Drinking stories? I really don't have any. Oh, I still have that video of when I got drunk on my 21st birthday. I have that still. And it was pretty freaking hilarious. It's just like an iPhone video, but it was pretty bad. Like, I fell asleep by the toilet, like in the bathroom, but then it wasn't comfortable, so I like moved into the other part of the bathroom, and I was like, I was saying weird things. I can vividly remember it, oddly, which is weird, because usually you don't remember it. Where three people are side by side, the person in the middle is the dick, and the people on the side are the testes. The testes punch the dick until he says dick in the middle. Yeah, that's pretty stupid. Cool trainer Cody. Nice jumpsuit, queer. Seriously. Alright, let's move on. What's over down here? Nothing? Yeah, this gym is kind of boring. If Zatu wasn't fucking useless, I would own this gym with a psychic attack. Yeah, oh, you're talking about Sianwood Gym? Yep. Dave uploaded? Yeah, I know. Dave's becoming Proton John with his upload schedule. Montezuma was our new outcast. Rochambeau? Is that a 8th gen? Or, not 8th gen, 5th gen Pokemon? My Xbox Live gamer tag is Noble Scope. All one word. Capital N, capital S. Oh, I'm loving these people using Seedras, man. I can just own with Cool Trainer Nick. Did I catch? Oh, I did. We named him Will Smith because I was singing Just the Two of Us when I caught him with the Great Ball. Caught him with the Great Ball. It was great. He's in the box right now. I like the gym better in Soul Silver and Heart Gold. Yeah, me too. It's pretty cool in Soul Silver and Heart Gold. I love the whole, like, theme of it, the whole puzzle. I'm so disgusted. Sending dat friend request. Oh, Rochambeau. Oh, it's Rochambeau. Damn, I've never seen it spelt like that. Scope, you need to do with a mermaid. Do you want the mermaid me fish on bottom or top? I would like the mermaid to be on top, I guess. What did the right nut say to the left? What? I don't know. Dick in the middle. I don't know, dude. Okay, let's see. Oh yeah, I need to drop a boulder in here. A boulder! Balderdash! Hey, Scope, your mama's so stupid she left a car at the stop sign because it never turned to go. Oh yeah? Well, your mama's so stupid she has a very low IQ score. So, ha! Well, I'm so stupid, she's not very intelligent. How you like me now? Scoop, are you excited for South Park Stick of Truth? What is that? I don't know. Owned. Have you ever played Trials Evolution? No. How many badges do you have? Well, obviously 7 if I'm in the 8th gym right now. Derpicus! These boulders be symmetrical. They do. It's kind of funny. Liquid. The boulder fell through. Thank you, Captain Obvious. Alright, let's go fight some more trainers. Train R's. Up there's Claire, the bitch herself, the first gym leader we actually used to. Well, I'm so fat when God said, let there be light, he asked there. Out of the way first. I don't know. Any mama jokes just isn't funny anymore. Why is the middle guy being a dick? Jumping through the basement window. You say so, man. I can't wait until I learn Solar Beam, Thunder Wave, haha, that's dumb. Petal Dance. Yeah, that's weak. We're gonna have to switch out. But I'm stuck using Petal Dance! Synthesis, bitch. Oh, fully paralyzed, I hate you. Alright, let's see who else we got in here. I trust Fry to do the right thing. Add me as your friend! I barely ever go on Xbox, and when I do, I barely ever turn on Xbox Live, so... Don't you... Why did I use Dig? That was the stupidest thing I've ever done. Arrgh. Alright, go goddammit, why? And that was a level 37 Dragonair, jeez. That's old? Indeed it was. Can I dig out of here? Please tell me I can. Damn it! I hate this game. Salamence because it's pseudo-legendary. Yeah, they have to fish the boat out of the lava with their hands, hell. I guess after this there are no more challengers. I am the final countdown. Can you accept Steam friends? Yeah, I'll do it later. Later, next time I go to play Portal. Screw healthy pizza? There's healthy pizza? Ew! What's the point? If you're gonna eat healthy shit, eat a salad or something. Oh my god. Do I only speak English? I can understand and speak pequeño Spanish, and I don't know, I can read like very, very small amounts of kanji. Very small amounts. Very small, like just a little bit. The advanced chambers? There's the portal. I've never even played Portal 2 co-op, to be honest. Because of Congress, pizza is now a vegetable. Oh yeah, because they serve it at schools. So it's a... that's the stupidest shit I've ever heard of in my life. What is this country coming to? Thank God no purifying Pokemon in this game. You're telling me. Speak German? I don't really know how to. I don't really know any German, to be honest with you. Except for, other things. Alright, who do we have in front here? Alright, let's fight this scrub. Guten Tag, yeah, that's all I know. Rub a dub dub, there's a pug in the tub. Suck my testicles. Alright, what is this? Oh look, here's just the two of us lyrics again, but... Twitch TV. I just want to see what's going on here. Does say that, goddammit, why? 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 Okay, I'm sorry. I just had to check, like, the stuff. Dorkly laugh there. I know, that was so gay, wasn't it? I'm sorry.